Hello all students. In this session I will be dealing with the pantograph, and according to this, in this session I will be dealing only with the theoretical part of pantograph, and I will be doing another session which will be showing how to plot on a pantograph. So let us see what is pantograph. So pantograph, it is a graphical recording of the labor status which is helping us to validate about the progress of the labor, and also we can able to identify whether there is any deviations from the normal. Okay, so that is pantograph. Pantograph, it is nothing but a graphical recording. And what are all the features we are recording in that? We are recording the mother's condition and the fetal condition during the process of labor. So when the labor starts, and from that time we are recording the features of both the mother and the baby, and this will be helping us to identify regarding the progress of labor, and also to identify regarding whether there is any deviations from the normal. What are the principal features of the pantograph? So in pantograph, the uterine activity and the fetal heart rate, they are assessed in every 15 to 30 minutes. So in the first stage of labor, within 30 minutes we can able to assess the uterine activity and the fetal heart rate, but when it is coming to the second stage of labor, it has to be identified in every 15 minutes. Then vaginal examination, it is carried out every 4 hours. So these two are the principal feature behind the pantograph. Number one, uterine activity and the fetal heart rate is assessed every 15 to 30 minutes. Vaginal examination is carried out in every 4 hours. Why we are plotting the pantograph? So the purposes behind the pantograph is that we will be recording accurately what are all the clinical observation during the stages of labor, especially the first stage and the second stage of labor. Then we can able to identify the difference between the latent phase and active phase of labor. So in the coming slides it is there what is latent phase and what is active phase. So to identify the difference between latent phase and active phase, we need the pantograph. Then from the pantograph we can able to identify whether there is any deviation from the normal pattern of labor. Next, we can able to monitor the progress of labor, and also we can able to monitor the well-being of mother as well as the fetus. So these are the purposes of pantograph. So pantograph, clinical observation is recorded very accurately in it. We can able to find out the difference between the latent phase and the active phase by using the pantograph. Pantograph will help us to identify all the deviations from the normal pattern of labor. It will help us to monitor the progress of labor, and also it is helping us to monitor the well-being of mother and the fetus. So this is the pantograph. If you are seeing this, here we are putting the name of the mother, writing the name of the mother, in which gravida she is, whether she is in G1 or G2, which para she is, P1 or P2 or P3. Then hospital number, that is, it's nothing but the IP number, date of the admission, time of admission, and if the members are rupture or not at the time of admission. So here this plots, this area, it will give you the information regarding the fetal heart rate. This here, it will be regarding the information regarding the amniotic fluid. This column, it is giving the information regarding the molding. This part, this session is giving you the information regarding the descent of the head and the cervical dilatation. Then here you can able to plot the hours and the time. Here the number of contractions per 10 minutes. This one will give you regarding the oxytocin administration and how much drops per minute, whether any drugs has given or not. What is the maternal pulse and BP will be identified. Both are identified in this. Then temperature will be written here regarding the urine, like urinalysis result of protein and acetone, it will be giving here. Okay, and what is the volume of urine? So this is the partograph which was modified by WHO. But nowadays we are not using this. We are using the simplified partograph by the WHO. So in the next session, I will be showing you in detail how to plot the partograph. So patient information, you will be writing the name of the patient, Mrs. So and so. What is her obstetrical score? GPLADT, that gravida, para, then if abortions are there or not, death, term, deliveries. So all these things you will be plotting in the obstetrical score. IP number of the patient has to be written, date and time of admission has to be written, and status of the membrane, whether the membranes are ruptured or whether the membrane is still intact on admission. Okay, so that has to be written in the patient information. In the patient information, you will be writing what is the name of the patient, regarding the obstetrical score, hospital number or IP number, date and admission of the patient, time of admission, and the status of membranes on admission. So next is fetal condition. So the fetal condition, fetal heart rate has to be mentioned. So that is recorded hourly during the first stage, and in the second stage, with 15 to 30 minutes time period, we have to plot down. Okay. So fetal heart rate during the first stage of labor, half an hour to hourly, or in the second stage, 15 minutes to half an hourly, we can able to plot. Liquor amniae will be observed when the membranes are ruptured, and it is recorded as follows. You can able to write I if the membranes are intact. Okay, if the membranes are not ruptured, in the specific column you will be writing I. Then if the membranes are ruptured and if the liquor is clear, if the liquid is clear, you will be writing C. If the liquor is stained with blood, you will be writing B. And if it is meconium stained liquor, you will be writing M. So I, C, M, B are the letters used to record regarding the observation of the amniotic fluid. If the membrane is intact, you will be using I. If the membrane is ruptured and when the clear fluid comes out, you will be recording it with the letter C. If the liquor is a blood-stained liquor, you will be using the letter B. And if it is a meconium-stained liquor, you will be recording the amniotic fluid as M in the partograph. Next, regarding the progress of the labor. So, cervical dilatation is plotted. And on the time of admission, it will be zero. But if you're seeing the simplified partograph, the cervical dilatation is starting from the 4 centimeter. So from the 4 centimeter only, we have to start. And see the points of each dilatation. Whenever you are plotting the dilatation of the cervix, that points, it is joined by the line. Then we can able to see that particular plot or particular area, it is divided into two phases, that is latent phase and active phase. So what is latent phase? The phase from the onset of labor to a dilatation less than 4 centimeter. Okay, from the starting of the true labor pain till the dilatation less than 4 centimeter, that is termed as latent phase. But if you're seeing in the simplified partograph, only active phase is there on the partograph, which is start from 4 centimeter to 10 centimeter dilatation. So that is another changes made by WHO in the partograph. That is, in the simplified partograph, if you're seeing, the active phase is only plotted there, that is from the 4 centimeter to 10 centimeter dilatation. So dilatation, the part plotting area, it is divided into latent phase and active phase. Latent phase, it is less than 4 centimeter dilatation, and active phase, it is from 4 to 10 centimeter dilatation. Then on the partograph where the cervical dilatation is plotting, you can able to see two lines. One line is alert line and another line is action line. So allot line, it is drawn from the 4 to 10 centimeter of dilatation, which is representing the rate of dilatation. And if whenever you are plotting, if the mark is moving towards the right of the allot line, it indicates that the dilatation is slow and the progress of the labor is delayed. Clear? Again, I will tell you, you can see two lines on the cervical dilatation plotting area. One line is allot line and the another line is the action line. Allot line is starting from the 4 centimeter to the 10 centimeter dilatation. And if whenever you start to plot after some hours, if your plotting is moving towards the right part of the allot line, it indicates that the progress of labor is delayed and the dilatation is slow. Coming to the action line, if you're seeing the action line, it is drawn 4 hours right to the allot line. Okay, after 4 hours, right of the allot line starts the action line. And if the cervical dilatation is reaching this line, then you should assess that, what is the cause of delay. So after that, whenever your plotting of cervical dilatation is reaching the action line, that is also indicating that there is a delay in the progress of labor. So that is the importance or signification of allot line and action line over the partograph. So both allot line and action line, it is indicating that there is a delay in progress of labor. Coming to the uterine contractions. So uterine contractions are also plotted or recorded on the partograph according to the strength and the frequency. Observation of the contraction is made half an hourly in the active phase of labor. So after the 4 centimeter of dilatation, every half an hour, the uterine contraction has to be noted and it has to be plotted on the partograph. And you have to calculate or you have to see the contraction for 10 minutes and the duration is calculated for each contraction. The duration is calculated in seconds. The number of the contractions you are calculating per minute and duration of each contraction is calculated in the seconds. So whenever you are calculating the duration, if a duration is less than, if one contraction is less than 20 seconds, you can able to use this dotted marking. You can able to put the dots over the plotting area, which is representing that one contraction duration is less than 20 seconds. You can use the slanting lines to plot if the contraction duration is between 20 to 40 seconds. It means that one contraction duration, not all the contraction, one contraction duration will be, if it is between 20 to 40 seconds, you can use the slanting lines. And if the contraction, if one contraction is lasting for more than 40 seconds, you can use the darkened area to plot the uterine contractions in a partograph. Okay. So how to plot the uterine contraction in the partograph? Dots represent that one contraction duration is less than 20 seconds. Slanting line indicates that duration of one contraction is between 20 to 40 seconds. And a dark area shows that one contraction duration, it was lasting for more than 40 seconds. So this is how you have to plot the contractions on the partograph. And also you have to plot regarding the oxytocin drug infusion and regarding the IV fluids. Which IV fluids is using? So usually we will use the ringer lactate. RL is used, and how much unit of oxytocin has put inside the RL? 10 units or 15 units, how much is that? And along with that, how much drops per minute has also to be recorded in the space provided. So partograph will also give you the information regarding the oxytocin and other drugs given to the mother, both in terms of the dosage and also in the drops per minute. Next is the maternal condition. You are also plotting regarding the maternal BP, pulse and temperature in the pathograph. BP is plotted every 4 hours by using a double-headed arrow. Pulse is plotted every 30 minutes by using the dots. And temperature is recorded every 2 hours that you can write in the space given. Okay. So BP every 4 hours, pulse every 30 minutes and temperature 2 hourly you have to plot. Also, you have to plot regarding the urine. You have to write regarding the information of urine analysis. So urine analysis, when it is done, routine analysis can be done and it can be tested for the acetone and the sugar content, protein and the sugar content. For both, it can be analyzed. And what is the result that you have to write in the area given below, given on the pathograph, which is giving information regarding the routine analysis of urine. Coming to the uses of pathograph. Pathograph, it is giving you the exact information regarding the progress of labor, and from one shift to another shift nurse time, you can able to transfer the information very easily. You don't want to explain all the things regarding the patient who is in labor when you are changing the duty shifts. So whenever you are just giving that piece of paper of pathograph to the other shift nurse, it from that pathograph, it is very understood that regarding the all information regarding the patient who is in the labor. And it is also a time saving thing, that is, you can able to save the time by writing all the information in the pathograph. No other explanation is needed in the nurse's note regarding the patient. Only the pathograph is enough to explain regarding the complete and factual information regarding the mother and fetus who is in labor. Okay. So that's all about pathograph. So in the other session, I will be showing you like how to plot the pathograph. Thank you, students.